Welcome to this video series on creating Bluetooth low energy or wireless LAN tests with Keysight X8711A using LabView. In this episode, I will create a LabView project and demonstrate all of the steps and procedure to establish an instrument connection using 34999A driver. This is a mandatory step before we can perform any BLE or wireless LAN test.
Before I start, there are 3 steps to establish the instrument connection, which are the step 1, step 2, and step 5. Step 3 and step 4, I'll demonstrate them in the next video. So to communicate and control the 34999A module, a KT34999A driver is needed. So this driver is supports for 32-bit and 64-bit platform. So after understanding all of this, let's get started. So first, to reference the DLL into LabView, you right-click at the block diagram, you find the connectivity, and .NET, and a constructor node. You can always use the pin button here to create a window for this. So we create a constructor node, we browse the DLL, and we find the DLL that you want. Yeah, that's it. So this one, you click and select OK, and you can see the Keysight IoT device test here. You expand it and find a KT34999A. Click OK. So this is the instance that we created. And yeah, that's all for the step 1. So let's proceed to the step 2, create an instrument session. So first, we create a property node. And we link the reference port together. And the property, we select the COM port. And next, we create an invoke node to access the method to do the work for the class. So we will link the reference port together as well, and we select the method of connect. Okay, so let's do one more example. We create a property node, and we link the reference port together, and this time we select the IDN, which is the identity information. So in this case, we read the IDN from the driver. So we change the COM port into the write method, and we create a constant for this. So how do we know the COM port number that we want? So we go to the device manager, and we can see the ports. You double click it and you can see the number. So at here, our COM port number is 40. So I will input a constant of 40 into this one. And next, we need to input the resource name. So actually, the resource name is referring to the visa address. So we go to the connection expert, and we find our visa address, and we copy it. We create a constant and paste into it. And yeah, that's it. Simple, right? So next, we create another constant for the timeout. And the timeout here is referring to the milliseconds, so we input about 2000 milliseconds, which is the 2 seconds into this one. And the IDN string, we create an indicator for this. So in this case, we read the IDN from the driver and it will show at the IDN indicator here. So that's all for the step 1 and step 2. And before we end the whole program, it is always a good practice to end the test with a disconnect method, which belongs to the step 5, close the session, which means close everything. So what we need to do now is we create one more invoke node, and we link the reference port together as usual, and we select the method of disconnect. And one last thing is you need to connect all the error ports together. So at here, you create a control for this. And you need to link all the error ports together. And lastly, you create an indicator for the last block. And yeah, that is the whole program of this test. So now we connect the instrument to our PC and we run the program.
We open up the front panel and we run the program. So here is the IDN string read from the driver. So this means the connection is already successfully established. That is all for this tutorial, and I hope you enjoy watching this. And I will see you again in the next episode.